So now we'll discuss about the topic motion. Motion is the action of moving. Yes, can anyone just read it out? If you have the books with you. Yes, Tanushree. Page number 10. Unit 2.
Yes.
Unit 1, week 2. Yes, Tanushree.
Motion. Motion is the action of moving. When an object moves, there is a change in the position of the object with respect to time. Types of motion are given below. Translatory motion. In the translatory motion, all the parts of an object move the same distance from one point in the space to another in a given time. Translatory motion is also called translational motion. This motion may be along a straight line or along a curved path. Translatory motion along a straight line is called rectilinear motion. Translatory motion along a curved path is called curvilinear motion. A train moving on a straight track and a caterpillar crawling on the ground are some examples of translatory motion.
Yes,
rotational motion.
Okay. When an object moves in a Tanushree, one second. Okay, that's fine. So, what is the other name of translatory motion? What can it be called? Yes. What can it be called? Translatory motion moving along a straight path is called as rectilinear motion. Yes. Yes, Vilohit. Yes. What can we call as if the translatory motion is moving in a circular path, then we call it as
rectilinear motion, ma'am.
When it is moving in a circular path. Yes, Ashwin, want to say something? Ashwin wants to give the answer. Yes, switch on your cam, everyone. Yes, Jashwan.
Yes, ma'am.
Can you give me the answer? When it is moving in a circular path, when translatory motion is moving in a circular path, then it is called as, yes, Tanushree?
Ma'am.
Tanushree, you can unmute yourself.
Ma'am, when it moves in curved path, it is called curvilinear motion.
Okay, yes, that's good. When it is moving in a circular path, then it is called as? Yes,
curvilinear motion.
Ma'am?
Can you tell
curvilinear
me?
Curvilinear motion, ma'am.
Can you repeat this point once again? These two points? This para, repeat once again?
Once again, ma'am.
So you all are not taking your books and sitting. Simply just listening to everyone. Ma'am won't ask us to read. So let us keep our books inside.
Ma'am, which para get, ma'am?
Switch on your cam. Page number 10.
Ma'am.
Translatory motion.
Okay. In the translatory motion, all the parts of an object move the same distance from one point in space to another in a given time. Translatory motion is also called translational motion. This motion may be along a straight line or along a curved path. Translatory motion, also a straight line, is called rectilinear motion.
Translatory motion along a straight line is called as rectilinear motion. When translatory motion is moving along a straight line, then it is called as
rectilinear motion.
When it is moving in a curved path, then it is called as
curvilinear motion.
Yes, good. Yes, Bharadwaja. Bharadwaja will not respond at all. Yes, Bharadwaja. Aishwita, switch on a cam, everyone. Abhiveer, are you there? Yes, Vishwan. Read these lines. Translatory motion, page number 10. Which one do you have the book with you? Yes, which one do you have the book with you? Switch on your cam, everyone.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, Joshit.
Ma'am.
Yes, Joshit.
Ma'am, I'll read.
Yes, Joshit, read once about the translatory motion.
Translatory motion. In the translatory motion, the tall parts of an object moving the same distance from one point in phase to another phase in a given time. Translatory motion is also called
translational motion.
This motion may be along a straight line or along a curved path.
Examples. Read the examples.
A train moving on a street from there, you read. Last.
Yes, which one? Which one will read this? Yes, which one? Read
a
it.
A train moving on.
Joshit, wait 1 second. Yes, which one? Read it. Read the example of translatory motion.
Ma'am, from a train moving on.
Yes.
A train moving on a straight track and caterpillar crawling on the ground are some examples of translatory motion.
Okay. So do you remember, can you remember now what everyone has read? Please look into the books. Do not simply sit without the books. Switch on a cam, first of all, everyone. Ronit, Bharadwaj, Rudranish, Agastya, everyone switch on your cam. Mahalakshmi, Harshit, Teja.
An object moves to and from it, its main portion is called auxiliary motion. Moment of a pendulum is an example of auxiliary motion. Motions can be periodic or non-periodic. Periodic motion is defined as the motion that is repeated after equal intervals of time. Periodic motion
is... Divishi, just 1 second. I want to give others also the chance because time is very less. Yes, Hanvita, you can continue.
Ma'am, I don't have course book, ma'am.
Why, Hanvita? Why you didn't bought?
Ma'am, it was in one box, ma'am. I did not get it.
Then how you are following? All the books you don't have or only science?
So, ma'am, unit 2 and unit 3 I have. Only unit 1 I should search, ma'am.
Okay, that's fine. Yes, ma'am. Yes, who wants to read next? Tanushree, I gave you the chance. Yes, Hitansh, you can continue. Joshit, I'll give you the chance.
Ma'am, non-periodic and periodic motion, ma'am.
Read from the first, periodic motion.
Okay, ma'am. Periodic motion is defined as a motion that is repeated after equal intervals of time. Periodic motion is seen in a rocking chair, a bouncing ball, a vibrating, turning fork, a swing in motion, the earth is in its orbit around the sun, and a water wave. In such case, the interval of time repetition is fixed. Hence, it is called periodic motion. Motion is said to be non-periodic.
Now you understood why it is called as periodic?
Ma'am, I read non-periodic also?
Yes.
Okay. Motion is said to be non-periodic when it does not repeat itself at regular intervals of time. The motion of a car driving on a busy street is an example of non-periodic motion as it runs at irregular intervals of time.
Okay, thank you, Hitansh. So these were the examples. So with the help of the examples, it will be more clear to you to understand about the periodic motion, like a rocking chair. A rocking chair will be moving periodically. It will be moving front, back and forth. So a bouncing ball and a vibrating turning fork, a swing in motion. So these are all periodic motion. They will be moving back and forth periodically. So because of the name, because of the actions, how we are, the actions done by the things, they are moving periodically. So that's why they are named as periodic motion. Even you can see a few images in your course book. The rocking chair, the turning fork, pendulum, isn't it, children? So these are all periodic motion. And what are the examples of non-periodic motion? What is non-periodic motion? The motion is said to be non-periodic when it does not repeat itself at regular intervals of time. So all these things are repeating themselves in a regular interval of time. When the motion is said to be non-periodic, when it does not repeat itself, okay? When it does not repeat itself in regular intervals of time. For example, moving of a car may even stop. While moving up to a certain, with a certain speed, it is moving on a highway because the road will be very clear in the morning time, at early in the morning. It will be clear, the road will be clear, so the car will move in a high speed. But when it comes into the, if there is a high traffic in the area, when it comes into more traffic, then naturally it will slow down. So it comes under non-periodic motion. It will not move periodically in a same time interval. So a car moving in a very busy road is an example of a non-periodic motion. So this was about the motion and its different types. So we'll continue with the speed and distance tomorrow because of very less time. So we'll continue tomorrow, go through this lesson. Unit 3 will continue tomorrow. So go through this lesson, children. So tomorrow I'll continue with this lesson. And what about what you have to sing the song? So tomorrow, as Dean Ma'am told, that we'll be having a competition tomorrow in the last period. Yes, who is going to sing? Yes, Rikshita. And who else? Srikshita, your voice is very bad. You can join again. I can't hear you.